the Sports Pod. Today we're going to be troubleshooting the couch stretch, an extremely popular stretch, a very effective one, but also one that is done wrong a lot of times. So I harp on this one a lot. It's kind of a pet peeve of mine. We're going to try and make this thing perfect. This is a great stretch if you have tight quads, tight hip flexors, some low back pain, some knee issues. Really just an all-around great stretch in that it helps prevent a lot of those things that just happen in life. Sitting at a desk tends to shorten some of these muscles up. Just general daily activities kind of beat some of these things up. So we want to lengthen them up a little bit, okay? So first thing we're going to do is just get into our couch stretch position. So knee is back towards the wall. We're using our stall bars here, okay? And from here, I'm going to lift the other leg up, and I'm going to come up to a kneeling position, okay? This is the first thing I see goes wrong. As you can see here, if you look at my low back, it's got a lot of extension through it. I'm kind of leaning on my front leg. I don't really like this. I want you to get in a nice pelvic and spinal position. So we're gonna sit up tall, and I'm gonna squeeze my butt and abs, and it was really subtle, but what you can picture there, if your pelvis is a bowl that's like this, we're gonna try and tuck it up so that it's level. We don't want anything spilling out of the front. So I'm going to squeeze my abs and butt and try and tuck my pelvis like this and get into a good spinal position. Okay? This is a good position for the couch stretch. Okay? From here, we can modify it a little bit depending on what we're trying to accomplish. Okay? If I'm trying to attack the quads, what I can do is move the knee a little closer to the wall. That's going to create more hip flexion and get more of the rectus femoris. Okay? If I want to target the hip flexor a little more, this one's a little more complicated. What I'm gonna have to do is keep everything tight here, that good neutral midline, and I'm gonna have to move everything from here up as one unit forward, okay? Making sure that pelvis stays tucked up. Okay? Both of those, whether it's moving the knee closer to the wall or gliding forward, should increase that sensation of the stretch along the front side of the leg here. Typically what happens when people try and glide forward, they end up overextending through the back, they let their pelvis dump out, and they lose that stretch. So it's really important, nice and tight, keeping all this tight, glide forward as a unit, and now we're really going to attack that hip flexor as we open that hip up into extension. Okay? We want to make sure we spend enough time here, so we want to take about 90 seconds to 2 minutes, making sure we spend time on both sides. And that is how you do a couch stretch appropriately. So some big takeaways. Sit up nice and tall. Tuck the pelvis, neutral midline, and then make sure we're doing it long enough, 90 seconds. Okay? So try out some of those tweaks, get that couch stretch fixed. If you need any more advice, any tips, or you have any issues with that, reach out to us at thesportspod.com. Check us out on Facebook or Instagram. And then get out there and move free.